guys. Welcome to our 8:30 a.m. at home workout today. Man, we got a fun one for you on Friday. Here's how it's going to start. You got 5 rounds of shoulder taps. So that plank position on the ground, going back and forth, tapping the shoulders. We may also do these on the wall, inverted if you guys really want a challenge, right? Then we've got 20 Cossack squats today. So it's a little bit different movement, something we haven't done before. So it's a very wide base. We're gonna lunge to one side, then to the other side. Now you guys can do this holding a dumbbell if you're experienced. I highly advise against that if this is your first time. A lot of this plays into your mobility and the ankles and the hips and other things as well. So we're gonna get into that as we go. So that's for quality, definitely not for time. Then we get into the fun stuff. Been a thing these first 2 weeks, we're coming back with 50 leg blasters. So that leg blaster, an air squat into a jumping lunge, 50 times. And we've got 50 standing dumbbell presses, nice and controlled. We're gonna use, I think, 30s, 35s. You guys can upgrade that weight if you want. This is something where I want you to be able to do a set of 20 if push came to shove. It doesn't need to be overly heavy this morning. And then we finish up with those same dumbbells, or if you want to upgrade, go heavier, and you just 50 reverse lunge steps, 25 on each leg. So you're gonna be surprised at the volume and how you feel, especially if you're new to those Cossack squats. So you wanna ease into things today, kind of play it by ear, see how you feel on Monday. If you feel good, awesome, then we know next time we do those squats, we can add some weight, or you guys can upgrade. But I think the overall volume of everything today is gonna add up pretty quick. So let's review these movements. Let's get you guys loose. Let's talk about what we're doing, then we can rock and roll. All right, so we're gonna start with just 10 good air squats. Get these legs warmed up, right? Now, Brayden and I have already been warmed up here. Hopefully you guys are a little bit as well. Should make these squats a little bit more manageable. Sorry, I don't have my elbows. All right. So we're gonna test out the shoulder taps first. Now we've done these before, so all we're looking is a plank position, on the hands, core tight, shift the weight, tap, shift the weight, tap. The wider your foot base, a little bit easier this is gonna be. Nice and controlled. We're not trying to race through these things, right? Okay, then we're gonna get into these Cossack squats. So for you guys, here's what we're looking for. Let's just test mobility, see if we even have the ability to get in that position. So right now, hands on the ground, I'm really gonna lean to one side. Now, my heel is off the ground here. Toes are pointed towards the ceiling. It's a really deep stretch in the adductor, okay? We're gonna go to the other side. All right, so kind of the first things first. Can you get this leg that wide? All right. You can tell I'm leaning forward. Okay, next thing. We're gonna go to a regular squat stance. We're gonna reach down and grab our toes. We're gonna pull the chest up. We're gonna hang out down here. Now, do you guys have the ability to sit in a deep squat like this, okay? Can you get your hamstrings on your calves? Can you bring your hands up here, prank position squat? Can we chill in that position? Or do your heels come off the ground? All right. So if we struggle with any of that stuff, these lunges or these squats, be a bit of an issue. We're gonna stretch out the hip flexors for just a second here. You might feel tight there. Really open up the hips. Okay. So now, we're gonna test these things out. So here's what I want you to do. Take a very, very, very wide stance. Actually, these, the wider the better. Now the kicker is, on our working leg, we wanna keep the heel on the ground, and we don't want the knee to track really far in front of the toes. We'll probably move a little bit, and that's okay. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna lean to one side, or we're just gonna go down to about parallel. Let these other toes come off the ground, it's okay. All right, keep those hands out in front of your chest up. Let's go to the other side, just that parallel. We're gonna get in a couple reps to each side, just play with it, all right? All right, feel pretty good, you get to parallel. Now we're gonna try to bottom out in this squat. Now we're gonna go back, now notice, heel is flat, toes are up. I'm gonna shift my weight to the other side. Okay, my chest is up. I'm not leaning forward on these. Okay, so ankle mobility, hip mobility plays a big role in this. So from the side, I wanna make sure like keep that chest up, right? Like imagine you guys could hold on to a dumbbell or a kettlebell or a barbell on your back. If this stuff starts to happen, then we have to lean forward. I want you to shallow up the range of motion. I want you to go to right at parallel so you can try to keep that chest up, right? Trevor, what if these things are just a really big issue and I struggle? Okay, here's how we're gonna do this. For the first few rounds, all I want you to do is put the hands on the ground and then stretch out the adductors. You can let the heel come up, just like we did to warm up. And instead of doing 10 to each side, you're gonna do 5 to each side and just hang out in the bottom position there. Then you're gonna stand up, and you're gonna do 10 really good air squats to finish off that round. So we're just gonna try to work on the mobility, right? If you can really push the depth with the air squats, I'd like to see you bottom out, chest up big, nice and slow. So that's if we struggle with any of those movements. All right, next, let's get into the 50 leg blasters here. So I think you guys know what these are. Let's just go through two of these. So first and foremost, good air squat, lunge, back knee kisses the ground. Go back into an air squat, back knee kisses the ground, chest stays up. All right, these dumbbell presses, we're just gonna do 5 reps. So we're looking for abs tight, legs tight, elbows slightly below parallel, press, lock out. Strong, we're not leaning back. All right, we got 50 of those to finish up. Then we go into these reverse lunge sets. So if you want to upgrade your weight, do it. If you want to stay the same, which I'm probably going to, we step back, back knee kisses the ground, my chest is up big. Oops. All right, so that's a slower, more controlled movement than what the leg blasters are going to be. All right, so for that part, with the leg blasters, with the presses, and with the reverse lunges, it's 50 reps of each straight through. The first part to this is the shoulder taps and the Cossack squats. 5 rounds, 50 of the taps, and 20 of those squats, 10 on each leg. So remember, if you're gonna scale back those Cossack squats, it's gonna be 5 on each leg, just stretching out the adductors, that really wide foot base, and then 10 really deep air squats, as low as you guys can go. All right, we've got about 1 minute. We're gonna rock and roll, grab a quick drink, get your mind right. If you guys wanna try these on a wall, don't kick a hole in your wall at home, but give those a shot in a little bit of an incline. We're gonna go in 1 minute, guys. Good morning, Instagrammers. Thank you. Great job, guys. Remember, watch those air squats. Take a little narrow foot base. I want you to try to bottom out in a strong squat. Okay. When you're ready, go back to those shoulder taps. Thank you. broken, so if you're getting stuck at 30, it's okay, just stop there. So this volume's gonna add up, especially when we're getting those shoulder presses. Okay, into these squats. Guys. All right, last set of these squats. Here we go. Thank you. going. Set of 15, a couple sets of 10. We'll see how it goes here.
ready, jump in here.
Here we go.